Hi, I'm Pastor Eric, and the good news is that your life is caught up in the life of God through Jesus Christ. Jesus has brought you into God's reign through his life, through his death and resurrection. In Matthew chapter 10 today, Jesus will encourage you to stay strong in the faith, knowing that you are valuable to God. You are greater than anything in this world to God, and he has your future in his control. Let's hear the good news.
Redeemer. reach me. Mighty waves that surge around. For you are my place of hiding. You protect me from all strife. And with songs of your deliverance, you surround and keep my life. I will teach and will instruct you in the way that you should go. I will counsel and watch over you. The right path to you I'll show.
Alleluia. Fear not, everyone who acknowledges me before man. I also will acknowledge before my Father in heaven. Alleluia. The Gospel of Jesus Christ according to the Apostle Matthew. Matthew 10, verses 5a, 21 through 33. These 12 Jesus sent out, instructing them. Brother will deliver brother over to death, and the father his child. And children will rise against parents and have them put to death. And you will be hated by all for my name's sake. But the one who endures to the end will be saved. When they persecute you in one town, flee to the next. For truly, I say to you, you will not have gone through all of the towns of Israel before the Son of Man comes. A disciple is not above his teacher, nor a servant above his master. It is enough for the disciple to be like his teacher, and the servant like his master. If they have called the master the house of Beelzebul, how much more will they malign those of his household? So, have no fear of them, for nothing is covered that will not be revealed, or hidden that will not be known. What I tell you in the dark, say in the light, and what you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not fear. Those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny, and not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. But even the hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore. You are of more value than many sparrows. So everyone who acknowledges me before men, I also will acknowledge before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, I also will deny before my Father who is in heaven. Alleluia. Fear not, therefore you are of more value to God than many sparrows. Alleluia. This is the Gospel of Jesus Christ. Praise to you, O Christ.
Am I afraid to let go of the voices that do not produce life in me? I am every time I let myself be seduced by the noisy voices in my world, telling me that my little life is all I have and advising me to cling to it with all of my might. But when I let these voices move to the background of my life and listen to that small, soft voice calling me the beloved, I know that there is nothing to fear and that dying to these voices is the greatest act of love, the act that leads me into the eternal embrace of my God whose love is everlasting. You know, I remember one time after college going to a game night with some old college friends and some of their friends. And towards the end of the evening, people were talking about what it was like to walk away from the faith, the Christian faith. And I remember at that moment feeling like an outsider, like I didn't belong. They were bonding over their lack of faith. And I remember feeling like an outsider because of my faith. I remember feeling anxious at that time. And instead of thinking about my relationship with them or even my relationship with God, I was thinking about myself and how different I was at that time. Jesus says to fear the one who can kill both the body and the soul. It's like it's in those moments of that gaming party that I think this teaching of God as the ultimate controller of life can be a bulwark of strength for a believer. I was feeling like an outsider. I was letting their voices and my own voice be louder than the voice of God, whose voice is always more welcoming than human beings, always more truthful than we are, more loving than we are. He is love, after all, and is more powerful than any human voice. That perspective of Jesus is meant to strengthen us to see the higher things in hard situations. Jesus knows that you will face hardships by sharing his message, by making real his teachings and his healings that are found in God's reign. You know, I was reading through this passage, and I wanted to read some different translations. And I really came to love the Message translation of how the author translated the original Greek into our common tongue. Jesus sent his 12 harvest hands out with this charge. When people realize it is the living God you are presenting and not some idols that make them feel good, they are going to turn on you, even people in your own family. There is such great irony here, proclaiming so much love, experiencing so much hate. But don't quit. Don't cave in. It is all well worth it in the end. It is not success you are after in such times, but survival. Survival. Be survivors. Before you run out of options, the Son of Man will have arrived. A student does not get a better desk than her teacher. A laborer doesn't make more money than his boss. Be content, pleased, even when you, my students, my harvest hands, get the same treatment I get. If they call me the master dung face, what can the workers expect? Do not be intimidated. Eventually, everything is going to be out in the open, and everyone will know how things really are. So don't hesitate to go public now. Don't be bluffed into silence by the threats of bullies. There's nothing they can do to your soul, your core being. Save your fear for God, who holds your entire life, body and soul, in his hands. What's the price of a pet canary? Some loose change, right? And God cares what happens to it, even more than you do. He pays even greater attention to you, down to the last detail, even numbering the hairs on your head. So don't be intimidated by all this bully talk. You're worth more than a million canaries. Stand up for me against the world opinion, and I'll stand up for you before my Father in heaven. If you turn tail and run, do you think I'll cover for you? Here is what Jesus is saying to us. He is telling us that we belong to him, and therefore we belong to the Father of all creation, and we can rest assured that that relationship that we have through Jesus will create a full and whole life with the artist and sustainer of life. The student is not above the teacher, nor a servant above his master. It is enough for the students to be like their teacher. What creates belonging is the fact that living Jesus' teachings and ways builds us together, binds us together. Jesus' words can direct us when we start to feel anxiety about being public with his words, because those words that produce a powerful life of mercy, love, and restoration are a never-ending way of life given to us by Jesus Christ. So we are wise as serpents and innocent as doves. Know that things can and will get hostile, but be Christ-like, foolishly loving and open to the people that God has placed before us. The task that Jesus gives us is great and freeing and the ultimate purpose of our lives, but that doesn't mean it will be easy. This doesn't mean, though, we turn into arrogant, belligerent, rude, talking heads who don't understand that communication is an art and not a baseball bat. So go make disciples. We are about creating belonging with God and each other. It's really like this display a shepherd has in our fellowship hall. Rooted and built up in Christ, we do discipleship. We partner. We are stewards of the gifts that God has given us. We create fellowship with each other and our neighbors. We create relationships in which it all can be lived out. We develop. We invest. We create belonging for ourselves and others. Live our faith, and we follow the way of Jesus Christ. What is God calling you to do and to be? Jesus sends us out to share his kingdom. We are the salt of the earth, so don't lose your saltiness. We are the light of the world, so don't hide it under a basket. Am I afraid to let go of the voices that don't produce life in me? And know this, you are loved. You are valuable to God. God's plan and purpose through Jesus is creating the best outcome for your life. Be public with the radical love of God through Jesus Christ. Amen.
From a foundation, you say. Thank you.
Join me in confessing the faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Hear this and be comforted by this, brothers and sisters. Since Christ was raised from the dead, he cannot die again. Death no longer has any power over him. The life he lives to God. Alleluia! Because of our sins, he was handed over to die. And he was raised to life in order to put us right with God. The life he lives to God. Alleluia! Now may the God of peace, who raised from the dead our Lord Jesus, provide us with every good thing we need in order to do his will. And the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Amen. Go in peace as witnesses to the risen Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.